Greetings from Cuba. My name is Isora Enriquez Ofardil from Enrique José Varona University of Pedagogical Sciences in Havana. The presentation is about the bridges for professional development between Cuban ELT community and the British Council. I want to thank IATEFL for providing this opportunity to present this paper and the British Council for its support. The presentation will include some highlights on the British Council in Havana, the most relevant ELT projects and events, the links with the two teachers' associations we have in Cuba, lessons learned from this collaboration, and new opportunities to explore. I think it's interesting to start by saying that the British Council has been in Cuba for more than 20 years with a successful professional collaboration led by the 7 country directors we have had in Havana, with a small number of staff in the office, but very much committed to the successful of the different activities they lead. Among the most relevant ELT projects, I think we should start mentioning the content-based instruction workshops to support ELT reforms back in 1999 from K to 12, so that we were helped by Mark Gregson from British Council Venezuela to integrate language content from K to 12 with the contents of the priority subjects, math, history, and Spanish. Another project worth mentioning is the setting up of self-access centers in universities that helped us to design materials for autonomous teaching and learning. Self-access centers are still part of the strategy in higher education. Other two important projects have been TKT and Professional Award in Teacher Development. TKT offered thousands of teachers throughout the country to be trained in communicative language theory and learning. And more than 100 teachers were certified with TKT, with the international certification, and more than 1,000 of teachers were trained by local trainers. On the other hand, Professional Award in Teacher Development, guided by Maggie Milden, was a possibility to train 7 trainers, 2 quality assurers, and more than 85 teachers, so that it helped us, mainly teacher trainers, to develop teacher training skills and to design and deliver teacher training workshops complying with the requirements of the British Council. ELT conferences and roadshows have been organized by the British Council with the Ministry of Higher Education. It has been a possibility to bring together teachers from different backgrounds to share good practice, to cascade lessons learned from the CPD workshops, and most importantly, or very importantly, to interact with international speakers. Roadshows have offered the possibility for taking teacher development to all provinces and train teachers on communicative methodology and on the application of the Common European Framework of Reference, which has been new in the strategy, in the ELT strategy in Cuba. Train the Trainer and ELT and ESP training workshops have been very useful to introduce the application of the Common European Framework of References and to use face-to-face coursebook in universities. Assessment literacy has been very important to develop assessment tools for the new certification system in Cuban higher education, and also it has supported the participation of Cuban teachers, of Cuban researchers, in new directions in English language assessment in Latin America. The academic writing workshops have provided us with the skills to develop such skills in a number of professionals from different fields in the country. We had the pleasure to have Tania Pattinson a year ago. The workshops on ICT in distance education have been very useful in these times of pandemic. The association and the links of the British Council with its partners has been developed by signing agreements with the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Higher Education. As a result of this development, in 2017, a unique program started when a number of teacher trainees from undergraduate programs in the Faculty of Education of Foreign Languages at Verona University, a group of trainees could get together to have practical teaching and training skills for teaching the four basic skills. So for the first time, teacher trainees in undergraduate programs were able to participate with international experts from St. Giles Educational Trust in these training workshops. It then developed into other workshops, also incorporating experienced teachers, university lecturers in other universities. So that as a result, we have teacher trainers in Cuba have now a better understanding of a practice to theory methodology for effective teacher training, and also a practical training on communicative lessons. This classroom in action was the birth of the project Mentors in Action. In August 2019, in partnership with the British Council and with support from the British Embassy in Havana, the St. Giles Educational Trust developed a two-week course for a group of recently graduated teachers from six Cuban provinces with a cultural and social program so as to build up upon the areas covered earlier in Cuba. The program is now a robust, organic, and sustainable project to provide in-service training courses for trainees, undergraduates, newly graduated, and experienced teachers throughout Cuba. Policy workshops have been also very useful to help Cuban Policy Group for Higher Education develop an approach to ELT curriculum renewal in Cuban universities with a view to achieving exit levels of B1 for graduating students. As a result of these policy workshops led by Alan Puvernes, we have redesigned the ELT strategy for curriculum renewal and the implementation of the new ELT policy. Teachers from K-12 have also benefited from the teacher training workshops for advisors and teachers from different backgrounds. The materials writing workshops with K-12 authors have been very useful to improve the tasks in these materials. It's useful, I think, or interesting to share with you the associations and the links with the William Shakespeare British Studies Group from the Faculty of Education in Foreign Languages at Verona University in association with other institutions such as APCELI. Teachers, trainees, students from all educational levels have been involved actively in important celebrations for Cuba and the UK. I just want to highlight two of them. During the celebrations of the British Week in Havana, we have a language festival in which different children, families, teachers are involved to learn more about the British culture and to enhance language learning. Besides, it's important to mention the ESSE Award developed during the visit of the royal family in Havana. The links with teachers' associations in Cuba are strong. APCL, one of the associations, has been supported to participate in Hornby Teachers Associations in Latin America in 2019. It has been supported to deliver the workshops as part of the Hornby Award in 2020, to deliver a number of conferences both face-to-face and online, and very recently in association with IATEFL, we won the Prelim Award, and so 48 school teachers from remote areas facilitated by International House Bristol could participate in a language practice course. So now we want to thank also IATEFL for this opportunity. Jelly, the other association, the other teachers' association, has a tradition of collaboration with the British Council. I want to highlight now two of these projects. First, the Hornby Award 2021 to provide a set of online training workshops for K-12 young teachers in remote areas from different provinces. The workshops are running now successfully. Another one is the innovative project called Learning English is Fun to enhance English in early ages. As a result of home videos filmed by teachers, now we have a set of videos created with the help of Jelly, teachers and parents. They were created by children who were filmed at home. They have also developed other initiatives to engage children in the Earth Day celebration and other activities. Here we can have a sample of this video. Now I want to move to the response of the ELT community in Cuba to COVID-19. Cuba has a tradition for the use of educational television to enhance English language learning. So we have used a number of the lessons that we had already produced for enhancing, for providing language practice during summer, mainly for adults. But we have also developed a number of lessons for K-12 students and teacher training schools, complemented in schools by study guide, by WhatsApp groups, and other initiatives.
So here today we have to begin a new unit.
These words, memories. These lessons.
What is this unit about? Think for some seconds about the topic of this unit. Is it about simple present? Is it about past events? Is it about future plans? Take some seconds to think of the topic of this unit. Well, it was very easy. Memories. Of course, this unit is about past events. We are going to see the simple past tense of the verbs. You should describe trips, journeys, past activities. Now it's time to copy the topic of our lesson.
So here we have another sample for teacher trainees in teacher training colleges.
To help you learn and practice English. If you noticed the title of the lesson, If I Had Known. So we have another conditional, but this time we are going to help you to talk about past unreal situations. And let's analyze this example. Do you remember this character? This is Monica from the TV show Friends.
Welcome back, students, teachers, and family. In today's lesson, we will continue deepening on the essential knowledge you need to improve your communicative skills. In today's lesson, you will talk about future activities and plans. Okay, and also future events, of course. Okay, here you can read the objective. Please copy if you want. To start with, you are going to listen to a song with new expressions, and you will copy them on your notebook.
We have also have to face the challenges imposed by COVID-19 to continue providing professional development opportunities to our teachers through WhatsApp, Telegram, Google Meet, Moodle, emailing, mostly these platforms, because for example, Zoom is blocked for Cuba. The most relevant topics have been creativity in English language education, teaching English to young learners, catering for inclusion and diversity in English language education, and applying neuroscience, among others. Most of these activities have been supported by the British Council in collaboration with the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Higher Education and our teachers' associations. I want to take this opportunity to express how proud we are for the response of the young Cuban ELT community to COVID-19. They have actively involved in community and social work, which means that through our programs, we have contributed to enhance moral and human values. So we are very proud because of that. The support to Cuban teachers to participate in IATEFL conferences, it's also very much recognized by the Cuban ELT community. So now, approaching the end, I want to refer to the most important outcomes, mainly in these last 5 years. I want to say that the British Council and the international experts have been very respectful of the Cuban sociocultural context. So firmly rooted in the Cuban sociocultural context, the new approaches to align English language education to international standards have been built upon the existing Cuban developmental pedagogy. There has been a clearer understanding of the common European framework of references so as to align curriculum renewal, assessment, and materials development to it. Lately, in the last 5 years, there has been an increased participation of a diversity of trainees, going from undergraduates to experienced teachers and university lecturers. I want to share the lessons learned from this collaboration, that involving more than one team in the delivery of the workshops so as to reach more trainees and favor more training hours is really very useful. The need of strengthening a cascading model of dissemination of the teacher training, so also to include hundreds of teachers who have been trained by the British Council throughout the years. There is a need of integrated actions from all stakeholders for a more coherent ELT collaboration with its partners and a more productive use of funds. And there is a need to measure the real impact of the British Council collaboration with ministries in Cuba. As opportunities to explore, I think that it is very important, it would be very useful to think of alternatives to provide language practice to our teachers, to identify other partnerships between Cuban and UK educational institutions to promote students' and teachers' mobility, to develop partnerships between Cuba, the UK, and third countries, mainly in Latin America and the Caribbean, because we have strong connections in education with these countries. Sponsoring guest speakers has been also very much appreciated by the Cuban ELT community. So to conclude, I want to express our gratitude to the British Council and also to IATEFL, because some of them have been leaders in IATEFL, for the possibility of interacting with these renowned authors. They all express inspiring words to us. I have selected for this presentation five of them. Cuba is known for the quality of education and public health it provides and shares with solidarity all over the world, proven by the cooperation of our doctors to fight COVID-19 in many countries, such as altruistic service. This altruistic service, they need English, of course, which is provided by the Cuban ELT community. So, among the quotations, I want to highlight the one given by Alan Puvernes. He expressed, "The inventiveness and professional determination of the Cuban ELT community persists." I want to share with the audience that the Cuban ELT community will continue to collaborate and strengthen the links with the British Council and IATEFL so as to continue teaching English in Cuba for a better world. So thanks so much for the opportunity.